Morning.
Good morning.
Right. I've got a super stressful day today. I've got to go into London later. I've got a couple of briefing calls. I've got a deck to get out. I've got to record this video. I've got to do a newsletter. I've got a list of things, but I've also got loads of stuff going on in the background. So I thought what I would do is try and apply some of the management guru productivity advice tips and see if they help. First up is to focus completely on one thing at a time. The trouble I've got is that the car's in the garage and waiting for a call. Matron has already called from school to say one of my kids isn't too well, I might have to pick them up. And my mother-in-law's got an eye operation and minicabs have been calling about when to pick her up, and I can't deal with one of those things in isolation. Which brings me very fast onto number two, which is to turn off all communication so that I can focus. And in this case, I can't because there's just no one else who's going to pick all this stuff up. Number three is to work really, really hard and outwork other people. Yes, I am definitely trying. And number four is to time box stuff so I focus in chunks rather than having a running to-do list. This is advice I use a lot and I like, but it's impossible to use when you've got things pinging at you. And anyone with a boss and a boss's boss and clients will understand it doesn't work a lot of the time. Then you've got 5 a.m, get up early, get back some time. Really hard to see how that helps, especially when you've got a household that needs to get out. You can't always just abandon them. I did go for a little run this morning, but I came back early to see the kids before they went off for school. Then there's the body is a temple, which links into your body is a temple workout. Well, we all do bits when we can, but a total focus on those things is just often not realistic or possible. Aligned to that is a rigid sleep schedule. I've already told you I've got a sick kid. And also about setting goals and big goals and looking ahead, which sometimes, I know we talked about it last week, really helpful. And other days it's just kind of get to dinner. Always featuring on the list is to marry well. Not sure about this as a piece of advice, because if you're already married, what do you do with it? And if you're not, who's trying to marry badly? Which leads me to my all-time favourite, which is to quit television. How joyless are these people? Don't they know the new Traitors is online and it's so brilliant?
I'm girding my loins.
Too much.
Where I get to with all this, and it is really informed by Dori Clark's work last week and the 10-year planning, is what do I focus on? What's the red thread around what I do? And for me, it is how do we take the good advice out there that improves our performance, it reduces our stress, it helps us to manage our time better and feel less time poor, but is actually practical and we can do it. And that is my focus and what I am going to be talking about a lot this year. So join me on that journey and I'll see you next Friday.